It's now time to display the content of the index page. I select the container for my loop. I add the Show Posts smart action. I use the main loop as the loop type. To define the loop structure, I set the item container and the repeated loop item. Now, I set the action for the looped elements. The first one is the post thumbnail. I add the post featured image smart action and I select one of the thumbnail size that I have created during the theme setup. I select the title and I add the post title smart action. For the paragraph, I use the post excerpt smart action. I use the post date smart action for the date. For the category, I set the post tags and category smart action. I choose to display the category, and because I want to display more than one item, I choose to use this element as template, so it will be repeated with the same style as many times as necessary. The loop is now fine, but because I don't want unnecessary HTML in my final template, I set the Don't Export action to the unwanted elements. To end the job, from the tree, I select the loop container, which is a link, and I add the post link smart action. I save and export the theme. I switch to my local WordPress to verify that my changes are successful. And I see all the posts with their content from the CMS. Now that the index is populated with posts, it's the right moment to take care of the pagination. I select the first pagination link. I add the post pagination smart action. I confirm that the link will be the element that will be repeated for each available page. And that's it. I just have to set the don't export action to the other unnecessary links. I save and export. From my local WordPress, I can see that my pagination is now fine. And the last item to convert for this index page is the subscribe link. From the tree, I select the link and I add a customizer field smart action. I set my field ID, the label, and the header settings section, and I decide to use the select and load page action. Choosing this setting will allow me to select any page as the target for my link from the customizer area. To replace the existing link with the one from the page that will be selected from the customizer, I add the post link smart action. And once again, that's as easy as that. I save, then export my theme. from my local WordPress. From the header settings section, I can select my subscribe page as the link behind the subscribe button. The page is currently empty, but in the next video, we will take care of the situation.